it's one of my favorite times of the year. There are a lot of different reasons for that. You know, from the family time that we get to spend together through all the things that we're doing as a church over this Christmas season. I love this time of year because it's a great reminder of what Jesus has done for us, but it also is a great opportunity for us to help people hear the story of Jesus for the very first time. So I'm just thrilled about this season. And when I think about this past week, whether it was Thanksgiving or now that we're in the Christmas season, the word that always seems to come up in my mind is the word gratitude. Just in this moment, in these days, in this season, I feel this immense sense of gratitude because of the gifts of Jesus that God gave me, and then all the gratitude, all the things I get to experience, like it's an amazing thing. And I think that's something that we're all looking for. That we all want to be filled with a sense of gratefulness. And we all want to have this moment where we're going, man, I really do feel like I have all that I need. Because we live in a culture, we live in a world where we just want, we want, we want more because we think it's going to fill us up. But until we find Jesus, we're not going to have that feeling. So we got to say, man, I want to have that gratitude that can only be found in Christ. And I think one of the easiest, best ways we can begin to have that feeling on a daily basis is through the act of giving. And the idea behind this is if I'm willing to give, that means I'm content with what I have. You can give your time. There's tons of serving opportunities over this next month. We have a parade coming up in just a few weeks that we could use some help at. We have the opportunity to give our praise, singing loud as we'll hear about today, to worship God and praise Him for who He is. We can give that. Or we can give our finances. About this time of year, every single year, Katie and I sit down and we talk about our finances for the past year. And we go, okay, what are we going to do in this year ahead? And every single time, we walk away from that conversation with a sense of gratitude because we have given to God what is His through the church. And we've seen what He has done because of it. And He has blessed us beyond our imagination. And it might not always be financially, but we know that we see Him show up all the time. And when I do that, when we do that, when you do that, a feeling of gratefulness comes. So I'm going to challenge you to consider giving. I know we as a church are grateful for the people who take that financial step. It's a big step. And it makes a huge difference. And I think out of it, you will find a sense of gratitude for what God is doing in your life. Pray. Jesus, we're so grateful for You. Thank You for giving us the opportunity to give back to You through our time, through our praise, through our resources, or whatever it may be. Lord, out of that giving, help us to find that sense of gratitude that only You can provide. For we love You.
All my sin and shame. you can't get undistracted. There's so many distracting things about life that it made me hard. I think it's hard a lot of times to come in here and not be distracted and not think about what we have going on after this or what we have going on for the rest of the week, or especially right now in the Christmas season, there are so many things that have our attention. And I think right now, this morning, in this room, we need to give all of our attention.
Every heart that is broken.
space, to make time, to invite you in and give you permission to alter and absolutely wreck our lives. As we move forward in our day, be with us, remind us of that presence, of that place that we can be with you. If we're just willing to sing, if we're just willing to ask you, if we're just willing to be loud and embarrass ourselves a little bit for you. Thank you, Jesus, for everyone in this room. Be with us as we go. In your name, amen. We're going to sing more. If you guys want to stay, we would love that. If you have made any decisions, we would love to celebrate that with you in the lobby. We've got cards with all of our information for our Christmas services out there as well.